the real question of how life thrives on Earth is with its history. When Earth collides with another planet, a Mars-sized planet, leads to the formation of the Moon, and our oceans form, including land. Now, life on Earth is ready to exist. And that's how Earth came to be the living planet. Nothing yet lives on land, but in the oceans, it's a different story. These are the first life of the oceans, like trilobites. Including Anomalocaris, Earth's first super predator, which is huge. Hiking with these, the first of vertebrates evolved to Acaspelaspis, a jawless fish. They may be jawless fish, but they can sense vibrations, detect danger, or find food. However, there are the other parts, such as Bronto Scorpion, a sea scorpion, however, there are other monsters of the oceans. Sharks do evolve here, even way before the dinosaurs and what's to come. Though the ocean's top predators, one of us sharing with other predators. However, this exists with us today. They're really old creatures from the past. This is Hinobaton, a giant salamander amphibian, which is the first amphibian. They evolved to Acaspelaspis, and fish evolved to amphibians. And this is a sign for what's to come. Amphibians have first caught onto land, and since then, they've begun laying eggs. But as time goes on, something changes. Instead of amphibian eggs, they evolve into lizard eggs. A new age has begun. These are the reptiles. Since plants inhale oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide, the atmosphere is full of oxygen. And when insect metabolism works, the atmosphere allows them to grow huge. And that leaves you in a swamp filled with giant bugs. However, nothing lasts forever, and reptiles must overcome them. And now, the age of reptiles has truly begun. Those become large lizard creatures, such as Dimetrodon, a creature was on its back to cool off. But as time goes on, things are about to get tough. A drought has come and animals are struggling. One's finding food, water, even shelter. And that brings us to the Permian extinction, the mass extinction. But that era was a Paleozoic era. We're now entering a new era after the Permian extinction, the Mesozoic era. And when a new era comes, that means new creatures. And it's the age of the dinosaurs. course, there's certain other creatures that are dinosaurs, sometimes for survival. But it wasn't enough, as dinosaurs reigned supreme. Due to the success of surviving in the Jurassic period, things really began to change. They're going to ignore sizes, the carnivores, the herbivores. Now, this is really an age of dinosaurs. But also, in Jurassic period, just dinosaurs, or dinosaurs continued to rule the land, the other animals that ruled the seas down below. These were the marine reptiles that are dinosaurs. They're also known as sea monsters. Now, so for us to talk about dinosaurs, the Cretaceous period. The Cretaceous period had the coolest dinosaurs, and it spread all around the world, went from cold to hot places. Since it's so diverse, the soy dancing species to go around. So there's the liver fishing, Spinosaurus. Well, Petra shares liver with crocodiles. We're probably going to get along with them pretty well. Also, there are the flying pterosaurs. Lots of aren't dinosaurs either. And there's also the duck-billed, such as Pterosaurus and Iguanodons. When it's a mouth, their paint looks like a duck. There's a head-hanging Pachycephalosaurus, or to headbutt all the time. Also headbutting on two carnotaurs. There are also Ceratopsians, which have horns, while others don't. There's also a lot of carnivores throughout the earth, the Giganotosaurus. Now, points up to 65 million years ago, in the Cretaceous period, we see dinosaurs as we know them today. Finish Triceratops. To the Army and Ankylosaurus. Here's a tail club for defense. Just a Triceratops used the horn for defense tail. So the king of the dinosaurs, Tyrannosaurus Rex. However, that is their fate. An asteroid hit the earth. That causes darkness. It blocked out the sun for years. Plants died, and temperatures plummet. With no way to quickly adapt, the dinosaurs sadly went extinct. However, since the dinosaurs died, that doesn't mean that all animals died. There were survivors, like little creatures. These were the mammals. that includes small horses. But since the dinosaurs died, are the ancestors still involved and still around us today? The birds. This era is known as the Cenozoic era, where evolution truly shines. Horses evolve, but other animals have evolved too. Like whales. Some horses are still around today, but others are extinct. Just like whales. Now, they're the largest animals ever. As time goes on, many more mammals start to evolve. And now, many more weird, unique animals of the world. Including our first ancestors, the Australopithecus. It includes the American lion. Now we get to the best part of the Cenozoic era, the Ice Age. In the summer, there's lots of grass. When winter comes, there are lots of snow, including ice. And includes one of the famous animals of all, the Smilodons, or saber-toothed cats. And the woolly mammoths. Including the woolly rhinos. The Isis are so close to the ancestors too. The Neanderthals. Which later evolved into humans. Some of these mammals went extinct, sadly, including Neanderthals. But that doesn't stop Earth becoming a living planet. There's other plants and animals going on today, and where humans have evolved to become more civilized than ever. Now, the whole population has doubled. And we can learn about it from our history of prehistoric Earth, of natural history.